The alarm is set for like a certain time, so you set it yourself. And then once the LCD shows the time and once it matches the alarm time that you set, the alarm will start beeping and the robot will run. And then it'll beep and move until the user finds and flips the switch off.
So our robot took up many components, but some of the most important ones were the Arduino 101 to run all the code and build the code, two motors to drive the robot, the breakout board to control the motors. We needed to use the shift register because we ran out of pins on the Arduino board itself, so we had to use it to add more pins to the board. And then we used the speaker and the switch turned off, LCD to show the time.
This is our flow chart. When we start, we get the time from the user's input, so it would be like a custom set alarm. And then it would set the alarm on the Arduino. And then if the time, the current time is equal to the alarm time, it would start beeping. If not, it wouldn't, and then it would like check again. And then it would start beeping, and then after, or like simultaneously while it's beeping, it would run around. And then we check if the switch is flipped. And if it is, then it would stop running and stop beeping, and that would be the end. And if it wasn't, it would keep running, and it would also check again if the switch is flipped.
So if we had a future version of our alarm clock, we would have the robot move in random speeds and directions instead of this kind of odd, almost 180-degree turn. We would use the ultrasonic proximity sensors to prevent it from crashing into anything. If you notice, when she turned off the switch, it took it a couple moments to loop back around in the code to check for the switch again. We'd like to fix that. Ideally, the user would be able to change the alarm time by using the like, app.